Mad. Let me tell you, my friend. Did you see her coming back last night? I'm telling you now, she came back home and she was wearing the exact same clothes she was wearing yesterday at 7 a.m. in the morning. You know what was happening there? Clearly she slept at somebody else's house. And who knows whose house it is? It could be even a different person than the last person she was sleeping over at. You know? A girl. And I mean, who is this person who can't even drop her off at her door? She came in walking from the gate in yesterday's clothes. Hi. I'm not judging. I'm just saying. I'm not judging. I'm just saying. Yesterday's clothes. 7 in the morning. Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. I'm Kopano Shimange and this is How I Do Things. The show where you send me your questions and I let you know how I would do things. Now you can take it as advice or entertainment. Use it, don't use it, do with it what you will. It is just me telling you what I would do if I was in your shoes. So welcome back to another cozy conversation. Today I've got my gumgelel, my scoop of water. Last time I had tea and it went cold, so this time my scoopo will do for me. I wonder if you guys are having anything else to drink as well. Let me know. Are you having some cranberry juice, you know, clear out the system? Are you having some tea, some rooibos, some green tea, some coffee? Let me know what you're having for today's cozy conversation. This is the most requested video. It really is. Ever since the first week of How I Do Things, you guys have been asking this question. And that is all about sex before marriage, as well as setting boundaries in relationships. Today's cozy conversation is going to be extremely interesting. And it is all led by questions that you guys sent to me. So if you have any questions that you want to send, head over to my Instagram and look for this picture right here at Kopano Shimange and send me your questions. Just reply and let me know what do you want me to talk about in my next video. It is in my Insta story highlights. So it's on my homepage. Just click on the purple little circle that says How I Do Things. And it's the first picture you will see. Click reply and let me know what it is you want to chat about. So, like I said, this is definitely the most requested video and I understand why. And you know, when I started How I Do Things, it was always about what questions would I have if I was younger, and going through my life even right now, it's really forcing me to think about things that I've never thought about before. And it's also forcing me to inquire and ask people that I trust, like my friends and my family, my older sisters, for advice so that we can come here and actually have some really good things for you guys. It took me some time to actually do this one, because I had to confront myself. I had to think to myself about this very same topic and look at how I approached this when I was dating. How did I approach sex before marriage? How did I approach boundaries in relationships? And I learned a lot. And I think the relationship that taught me the most about boundaries in relationships is definitely the one where I am in now. I'm married to the man who taught me a lot about setting boundaries, because he's a very respectful person and he respected me enough to actually help me to set my own boundaries. So this one's going to be very interesting. Let's not waste any more time. Let's just jump straight into it. So in all honesty, I was not a virgin when I got married. And I actually lost my virginity way before Voya. But now that I'm married, to be honest with you, I have a completely different view on things. I have a completely different view on sex, and I actually understand why people save themselves. When you're dating, you're just like, hey, you know, it's what people are doing. It's part of the relationship. It's part of keeping my man happy, is actually engaging in sexual intimacy with a person. And you're just like, okay, fine, this is part of dating. This is normal. You know, it's on the table. It's not negotiable. It's, you know, it's fun. It's nice to have it. It makes the relationship interesting, and it's part of dating. So it's fine, right? Right? Well, like I said, now that I'm married, I see things differently. You know, I see that I gave myself away too cheaply. And I'm not talking from a monetary point of view. I'm talking from an emotional point of view. I'm talking from an intimacy point of view, and even from a physical point of view, I gave myself away too cheaply. Now that I look at it, I see why people save themselves. I see why people see this as something so important, because it is. It is something that is so intimate. It is something that is so beautiful that I completely understand why it is important to save it. And I look at my husband now and I think to myself, you know what, this man is worth it. This man was worth saving myself for. And when I look at all the men that I had sexual relationships with before, I think to myself, they were not worth it. This man is worth it. And I look at it and I'm just like, I don't even know where those people are right now. I really don't. I thought I loved them. I thought I was in a good relationship. I thought they were worth it, but they weren't. They weren't. This power that I have, this, you know, this thing, this intimate relationship I have with myself and giving it to other people who God knows where they are. On a very serious note, I don't know where those people are. Only God knows where those people are. However, I gave them a very intimate experience with myself. And do I regret it? Yes and no. Yes, because I wish I had saved it for my husband. I wish that I had the discipline to do that. No, because I know that I went through those things for a reason. And I went through all of those experiences so I can be here having this specific conversation with you guys. So it is, you know, it's something in the middle. But I learned a lot in the process. And it's not just about saving yourself. But there's so many other boundaries that you have to set in dating that when I look back, I wish I would have been a bit stronger about those boundaries. But I'm happy that I learned about them in the way that I learned about them. So that's what I want to chat to you guys about now, which is saving yourself and intimacy and sex before marriage, as well as boundaries in dating. Because dating can ruin you. It really can. It can damage you in many ways, that when you get into a relationship with someone, there's a lot of fixing that you have to do together in that relationship before you actually even get into enjoying that relationship that you have with that person. And if you meet a person who's strong enough and is good enough, that person will forgive you immediately, which is something that my husband did. We went through what I like to call the baptism of fire in our relationship, because there were so many things that we had to put on the table and come face to face with. And to be honest, it took me a long time to forgive myself for the boundaries that I did not set in relationships, which is strange because my husband had so much grace when we were dating. The first 3 months, everything came out. And I had to deal with that because I did those things. No one forced me to do those things. No one held a gun to my head. I did those things. I did not set those boundaries. So I had to deal with the fact that I did it. No one forced me to do those things. I was conscious when I did all of those things, whether it was sexual or non-sexual, it's everything, you know? And then afterwards, he had so much grace and he forgave me for those things. And he supported me in forgiving myself. I had a lot of praying to do. I had a lot of things to get over afterwards. So yeah, so this video is a lot of the lessons that I learned. And if I was to talk to my younger self, these are the things that I would say to myself. And this is not even a far younger self. This is early 20s. These are the things that I would say to myself. The four important things I'd say, girl, these are four things that I want to tell you about dating and about intimacy and setting boundaries. Now, we do things differently. We're all very different people. And like I said, these are things that I would say to myself. The one thing that we also always have to remember, that we are on our own individual journeys with Christ. And I love the fact that to a very large extent, especially towards the end of the dating phase of my life, I built a really strong relationship with God and a really, really strong relationship with Christ. I really got to know my Savior. And that really helped me and guided me a lot. But we're all on our different paths and we're all on our different journeys. And like, you know, like I always say, use it, don't use it, or use it as entertainment, whatever you want to do with what I'm about to say. So these are the things that I would say to my younger self about setting boundaries and about sex before marriage. And do with it what you will. But I would really like to know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Let's have a conversation about this. This is Cozy Conversations, so let's get into it. Number one is to preserve your independence. This is everything, okay? This is in everything. This is not just about what you think or your opinion about things. This is everything, to preserve your independence. Let me tell you something. People break up all the time. There are people that I thought I'd never break up with. We are definitely broken up because I'm definitely married to someone else. But people break up all the time. The chances of you breaking up with your boyfriend are much higher than you having a divorce. People are just like, yeah, but divorces happen all the time. But listen, there are more people breaking up every day than there are people who are having divorces. It is much harder to divorce a person than it is to break up with a person. It takes legal steps and families and so many other things to divorce a person as compared to an SMS that can be sent to someone and letalan, it's over. So you need to remember that, that in dating, there's always a possibility that you guys are going to break up. And because of that, you need to keep your independence. You are like this. To God and to the government, you are single until you are married. Okay? So you are like this. Until you are married, then you are like this with another person. So you are not like this when you are in a, when you are dating someone. So you need to preserve your independence. And I learned this lesson the biggest with my husband. He was the one who really helped me to set the boundaries of independence. And he was just like, you need to have your own crib. You need to have your own money. You need to have your own transport. And this is not to say that he didn't spoil me. He spoiled me a lot. But I always needed to have that independence that should we break up, my life continues just fine. I have my own crib. I have my own car. I have my own money. I'm fine by myself. And that is the thing that we tend to do when we get into a relationship. We commit to a point where we then become dependent on this person. And I kept my independence till the last day. Okay, we had our tradition on the 22nd of September. I only moved out of my crib that weekend. The day after that, I think the Monday, that's when I actually moved out of my place. I paid rent on my place until October, I think. That's the last month. And that was because I needed to keep my independence until there was that level of commitment. And that was after the traditional wedding, which was Mahadi, right? After that happened, that's when I then moved in with V. No matter how many sleepovers you may have with your boyfriend, keep your independence. Because until that level of commitment has been made, then that person can still break up with you with an SMS. You can come back home and find that your clothes have been thrown outside and the person has broken up with you. It happens all the time. And this is not to say that you shouldn't work at building your relationship. Yes, you should. But that level, drawing that line and saying that I still need to keep this independence because you have not shown me that level of commitment to make me feel secure. And that is a line you have to draw, and you have to be very strict about that line. Like I said, I learned a lot of that from my husband, who was just like, listen, I don't ever want you to lose that level of independence until I've made that commitment to you. And that is such an important thing that I learned, and I wish that so many other girls would learn that, because I had made that mistake several times before even dating him. And I wish I had known that. And having that level of commitment to say that, listen, I'm committing to you by telling your family that I want to commit to this woman through traditional means, and then thereafter through the church, that is when you now know that, okay, this guy is stepping up. But until that stepping up has happened, I kept my independence. And I would definitely do that again if I had to redo the whole dating process. Number two is to never negotiate on your values and your morals. Yes, when you meet someone and you get into a relationship with that person is able to influence you. And to a certain extent, they should, because they should make you a better person. They should make you question certain beliefs that you have that are holding you back in life. However, there are those people who will make you question the wrong things, which are your morals and your values, the things that you have based yourself on, the things that your mother has taught you that are important to you, the things that are based on your faith as well. And I've been in those relationships where people then started to make me question some of my values and my morals. And it's only later when I then got to work on myself and to work on what is it that I believe in deeply, that I then realized that, you know what, there were people in my past who made me question these things. People can argue anything, guys. People can literally argue their point until they're blue in the face. And this is also where then sex before marriage comes in. If you want to save yourself, you can meet somebody who will argue the point that it's okay, there's nothing wrong with it, blah, 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 Jesus will forgive you, all of those things, and convince you otherwise. And that is a problem. You can't have a person who will convince you otherwise. Especially on things that are super important to you, your values and your morals, the fiber that makes you who you are, you can't negotiate on those things. You should meet a person who is able to respect those and work with you based on those values and your morals. But if somebody makes you want to change those things in order to be in a relationship with them, that is a red flag. And you need to ask yourself, why is this person making me question things that are deeply entrenched in who I am? Is it because maybe they are holding me back in life and that I could become a better person? Then that's a good thing. But if this person is actually making you go backwards in life, if this person is making you break down walls that are fundamental walls, that are foundational walls to the person that you are, then you can't have that. You need to uphold those values and those morals, and you can't negotiate on those things. And don't let anybody make you negotiate on those things. And if somebody does, then you need to be strong enough to leave. The one thing that I had to learn was that my boundaries that I set are my responsibility. I can't expect somebody else to uphold my standards or my boundaries. It is my responsibility. If somebody crosses the boundary, it is my job to tell them to move back and to tell them that they've crossed the boundary. I can't expect somebody else to uphold standards for me. I can't do that. It is my responsibility, especially in dating. When you get into marriage, it's a different thing, because yes, that person is on your side and fighting on your side. And if you find somebody who's able to help you uphold your standards and uphold your boundaries, then that is the right person. But if somebody's constantly trying to break down important boundaries to you, then that might not work out. You know, I know someone who has an important boundary, and you know, I admire her so much because she was able to get married as a virgin. And the person she married at first couldn't really take that, and they broke up. But he came back and he then upheld that boundary with her. And now they're married. And you know, I really admire, I've got a number of friends, quite a lot of friends, who got married as virgins. And I really admire them for being able to do that. And then I also have a lot of friends who weren't married as virgins, but they then decided to go celibate until they got married. And that's such a good thing. And I really admire people who are able to do that. So even if you've lost your virginity and you think to yourself, ah, I'm already unpure, it doesn't work like that. You are perfect in God's eyes. It doesn't matter what has happened. So even if you have lost your virginity, that doesn't mean that you can't decide to stop today. And that's your choice. It's not something that I'm pushing on you or anything like that. I think it is completely your choice. If you feel as though that it's something God is guiding you to do, then you should do that. And that leads me to my third point. Always be guided by God. The more I prayed, the more I put my head in the Bible, the clearer things became for me. The more I felt as though I was guided, the more I knew what to do. And that happened, like I said, right before I met V. I was in a relationship already, and because I was praying more, because I was speaking to God more, I was building a strong relationship with Jesus, I literally felt as though God was telling me to break up with that person. And I did. I came back from church one day and I was so heavy pressed by what God was telling me that I did break up with that person. And it was hard to break up with that person completely, to be honest with you. It took a long time to really break that relationship. It had to take, V had to come in to break it, that relationship with me. But it's because I was guided by God. I feel as though I was guided by God. And even now, I still feel as though I am. And that is because I'm constantly asking God, what should I do? I'm constantly giving him my day. I'm giving him my relationships. I'm giving him my work. And I'm praying. So scrap everything that I told you, because the most important thing for you to do is to be guided by God. Pray. Put your head in the Bible constantly. And that is how you will then get that clarity. That you don't have to ask other people what you should be doing. You ask God, what should I do? Because that is what happened with me. I was guided by God. And the more I was guided by God, the more I was okay with myself. Before that, I felt as though I was pleasing other people. I felt as though I was doing things that when I went back in bed and then I thought to myself and I thought about what would God think about what I'm doing, I'd feel guilty and I'd feel bad about it and I wouldn't feel good about myself. And that's why when we got into the relationship and I laid all my cards on the table, it took a long time for me to forgive myself. So always be guided by God. That is the number one thing that you should always do. Always be guided by God. It is your individual journey with Christ, so you need to be guided by God. Take everything to him in prayer and look out and listen, because you hear him by praying, you hear him by reading the Bible, you hear him in visions and in dreams, and some people hear him in an audible voice, but you will hear him the more time you spend with him. So be guided by God always. And number four is something that's for my quiet girls. Something that is, I haven't always been an outspoken person. And I'm learning to be an outspoken person. And I'm learning that in this relationship. And that is to, don't give people your power. You have your power. And as soon as you allow people to change your opinion or make you think otherwise, that's when you give away your power. And what do I mean by otherwise? I would have an opinion about something and I'd think, I want to do things this way in my life. And then I'd meet a person who would argue the point of seeing things differently and they would convince me to do things otherwise. And then that is what used to happen a lot with me. I was easily convinced of things by people. I had friends who could convince me otherwise. I had boyfriends who could convince me otherwise. If you put up a good argument, I could just flip over and just believe what you're telling me. Please don't do that. Learn to find your voice and learn to be okay with sticking with your opinion and sticking with what you think is right and what you think is wrong. This is for my quiet girls. This is for the girls who just feel as though sometimes, you know, they can be pushed over. Sometimes when they feel as though they're scared to speak up. I used to be that person who used to have a lot of internal conversations, who would do what people tell me to do because I was too scared to tell them what I thought I needed to do. And I'm learning, still learning till now, how to not do that anymore, how to stand my ground and say, no, I don't believe in that and I'm not going to do that. Or listen, this is what I believe. It's fine, thank you for sharing your opinion with me, but this is what I believe and this is what I want to do. And it's still very hard for me because I almost feel like this thing inside and I feel guilty and I feel weird and all of those things for standing my ground. But it's important to stand your ground. Don't hand over your power to other people. Don't hand over your power to the person you're dating. It is still, even in marriage, it's still very important for you to still stand your ground in things that are important to you. And it is important for you to be a full person with their own opinion. That doesn't mean that you have to be a hard person. This is specific. I mean, there's two sides of the spectrum. There's the pushover and then there's a person who's so hard that they cannot be convinced of other things. Because marriage is about a lot of compromise. So I think that for the girls who are quiet, for the girls who are scared to speak up, for the girls who feel as though they can be easily convinced into things, the girls who don't want to make people unhappy or are scared of disappointing people. That's how I used to be. Don't be scared of disappointing people. Don't be scared of having your opinion and your opinion making other people unhappy. You need to stand your ground. You need to find your power and you just stick to your power. Don't hand it over. Don't hand it over so easily. Have your standards, have your boundaries and keep them because it is important. It is so important. I cannot even begin to tell you what it is. So those are the four things that I would have loved to hear from someone and the things that I learned a lot about setting boundaries and about sex before marriage. I think a very important thing that happened with our relationship is that we actually went to marriage counseling a year before we even got engaged. And then after we got engaged, it took a year for us to get married. And many people who've gone to marriage counseling will know that they encourage you not to have sex and to not sleep into the bed, same bed, or, you know, not to engage in that before, during counseling. And God, even in my relationship, spoke to me and said that, you know what, stop, take sex off the table. And I spoke to my husband about it at the time when we were dating, before we even got engaged, and he respected my wishes. And that is what's supposed to happen with the person that you're with. If you feel as though you want to take sex off the table, you talk to your person, even if you have engaged in it before, you talk to him and you tell him that this is something that's weighing heavily on my heart. This is something I've prayed about and this is how I feel. And yes, things may not go well, but if this is something that you feel as though that you've been really guided about, then do it. And that's the thing about the power that I was talking to you about. Then do it. But if you feel okay with it, and if you feel as though, you know, this is something I want to do, that's up to you. We all have our own journeys. And like I said, I was not a virgin when I got into this relationship. Sex was on the table when you got into this relationship. But after some time, God spoke to me and said, take it off the table. So if you pray and you feel that way as well, then listen to God, be guided by God. Why do I always feel like Sunday conversations are so heavy? Hey, cozy conversations. Yo. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know how you feel. I'll tell you now that sex in marriage is way better than any other sex that you could ever have outside of it. And it will definitely help you to rethink everything you ever thought you knew about it. It's a beautiful thing. The Bible encourages us to have it and have a lot of it and to enjoy each other. And I completely understand why, when you're with somebody who has given you that level of commitment, it's amazing. It is amazing. So let me know what you guys think. Have you been through this? Are you married and you feel as though you understand where I'm coming from? Or am I just crazy? Let me know in the comments down below. Let me know if you guys are enjoying the cozy conversations, because they're quite different, right? They're quite different from everything else that I've been doing throughout the week. We get to actually sit down and have a good cozy conversation. I'm going to continue with my lactational milk bar and my water. It's time for me to get the rest of the day going. But enjoy your Sunday, beautiful people, if you're watching this on a Sunday. And if you're watching this any other time of the week, make sure that you join us 7:30 South African time for the live premiere of the next video. But until next time, beautiful people, I'm Kopano Shimange, and this is How I Do Things. Gorgeous. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'm going to take my lashes off, take my makeup off, and absolutely have a nice little soak in the bath. It's a self-care Sunday. And I'm going to enjoy it. But until next time, thank you so much for watching my video right until the end. Please do go to my website, www.kopanoshimange, and become part of the gorgeous gang. And don't forget to click on this face right here and to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Bye.